Okay, so today we have Adam Ant and Goody Two Shoes, his debut solo single. So he's been requested a few times, so have Adam and the Ants too. And anyway, I went with this one because why the hell not? 3 minutes, 20 seconds. Gonna watch the video here. Might get blocked. I wouldn't be surprised if it does, but just know I'm watching the video. And yeah, so my first reaction to him, so let's get into him, talk about it after. Let's go. And he does sound familiar, the name. Well, there we go. Adam Ant, Goody Two Shoes. So, I have to say, just to say off the top, obviously, when you're a celebrity, when you're a known musician, whatever the hell, when you're in the public's eye, you have no privacy. My God. And as Adam puts it on here from the 80s, you know, being a star in the 80s, I feel like I don't know if there's as much paparazzi back then as today, but just watching people follow stars around today, it is weird. I mean, watching them outside their house or whatever. And I probably just said house like a Canadian, but anyway. But anyway, just talking about how you have no privacy and looking here on songfacts.com, because I like to know a few things about a song before I get into it. But apparently, Adam is a very private person, you know, private about his personal life and stuff like that. And I mean, yeah, you have the right to have a private, you know, life or whatever, and not want to discuss that stuff. You know, discuss about your work, but not have to discuss your family, your kids, or whatever the hell. I mean, yeah, you should have that kind of rights. But again, obviously, and even, you know, some press, you know, as it shows in the video, you know, guys, people who want to know more about you, who want to catch you doing something. You know, as you can see, the butler, I guess you would say, looking through the keyhole in the video, wanting to see Adam, I guess, have sex or whatever, and just wanting to know more about a person. And again, if you're a private person, I can imagine there's like that piece of press that's like, oh, he's private, is he? I'll see what I can get out of him. My goodness. Anyway, what I can catch him doing. This kind of stuff then becomes like a challenge, and it's just like, good Lord. Anyway, it's quite the job to have. But yeah, just this whole... these whole pressures that are put on you from society, from whatever, from the press, from the media, wanting to know more when you're a celebrity, and just trying to be kind of obedient, trying to be a goody two shoes, trying to be like put on the makeup and seem like you have everything together, even when you might not, and just trying to always put on some kind of a farce, or just trying to seem like you're always doing well, even when you're not. I mean, this is stuff that celebrities have to deal with, and again, a lot of people want the fame and fortune, but one thing that, you know, and maybe people would enjoy it. I'm sure there's those stars, there's those people, whatever, that enjoy the press or whatever. But again, it's one of those things that maybe you don't think about a lot if you want to be famous or whatever, that you have to deal with this kind of stuff. You have to deal with the press coming at you all the time, asking questions and just not being left alone. I mean, goddamn, I can imagine, you know, not being left alone, just going out wherever, going to your car, going outside of your home, and people just bugging you. I mean, there's that famous Kanye West video, whatever, from way back or whatever, when people were asking, how's your day, or whatever the hell he said, and Kanye said, go fuck yourself. But anyway, and Kanye has said a lot of different things since then. But yeah, and that just comes to mind, and again, just talking about how, I guess, Adam was done with this. He was done with these kind of people, with people kind of intruding your life, and just like, you wanted to be like, just go away, good Lord. And anyway, so yeah, I just loved his take on this, and kind of a rebellious theme for many different people who felt this, you know, throughout the years, many different stars or whatever. You know, he's kind of speaking for those people, I might say, or just speaking for himself anyway, just telling other people to just like, you know, calm down, good Lord. But anyway, really enjoyed the whole point of it, I have to say. And yeah, just to talk about the song here, I love the whole big band feel you get from it because of the trumpet and the saxophone here. And I guess I will talk about the personnel. But I have to say too, and I don't know why this came to mind, but just from the start of the song, and I know the song is not a country song or whatever, but he has kind of a country twang to his voice. That's what came to my head. Adam does. And I don't know what Adam has done in his career. I wouldn't imagine that he's ever done a country song, but he just had one of those voices where I was like, if he ever did a country track, I feel like it would really be good. I mean, I feel like his voice would fit it well. And I'm not even the biggest country fan, but that's what came to my head. He just had kind of a twang to him, which I enjoyed. And again, a great, catchy, upbeat, energetic track. Great repetition too. You know, the whole point of, you know, you don't drink, don't smoke, what do you do? It's just, it's going to be stuck in my head, I think, the rest of the day. Just a great melody. And again, all you can ask for in a song is it to be catchy and get stuck in your head, and then it's going to sell some records, I would think. But anyway, looking at the personnel here, Adam Ant on vocals, do you believe it? My God. Anyway, he's also on bass here and on acoustic guitar. It's hard to see what the way they have it laid out here on for the album on Wikipedia of the personnel, but there we go. And then Marco Peroni, I want to say, who is also just known as Marco, so there we go. He's on guitar here. And then we have Bogdan Wigslin, I want to say, he's on drums here, and he is prominent, I have to say, from the beginning to the end, with the whole bop bop, how the song kind of ends off on a drum beat, I might say, and how it kind of echoes, and the song finishes off there. But there we go, Bogdan, I want to say, anyway. Then Martin Drover on trumpet, again, so prominent in the song. Jeff Daly on saxophone. So Jeff and Martin were just obviously big pieces of the song, because whenever there's a trumpet or a saxophone, or a trumpet and a saxophone on the track, it just makes, to me anyway, it makes the track feel bigger than it is. It just, because, I don't know, those instruments just put an extra layer onto a track, obviously, and makes it sound a little bit more luxurious to me. I don't know, that's just the stuff that comes to my mind, and I just love the video too, and, you know, showing the trumpets and such. And again, the video seemed fun, and he was having fun too, you know, just showing what he deals with on a day-to-day basis, whatever. And again, I talk about how he's, you know, the whole goody two shoes thing, but had the way he dresses, you know, almost reminds me of like Sid Vicious or something, and just showing that he's being himself in this world. And you know, I just love that so much, and the way he went about this, and how he was kind of taking the piss, as people might say, out of, you know, these kind of people who just want to know everything he's doing at every point of every day. Anyway, so going on here with the lyrics, I guess, because I said everything I wanted to say off the top. With the heartbreak open, so much you can't hide. Put on a little makeup. Again, I love, as I was talking about earlier, just a repetition of some words, you know, makeup. Again, I just loved how we did that. Make sure they get your good side. Again, just how you want to look your best for the press or for these photographers, whatever, at all points, and just that kind of pressure that they put on you. But how Adam might be saying, like, I don't give a fuck, you know, get my bad side if you want. And the words unspoken get stuck in your throat. Send a treasure token. Write it on a pound note. Again, I just love that that whole dynamic he's doing there. But again, it's just like, I guess when you're talking to the media, talking anywhere, you know, if you get stuck or whatever, just, I mean, make something up or just keep going. You don't want to seem like you're not doing well or that you're not great at, you know, grammar, words, whatever. If you want to make sure that you know what you're doing at all times. And it's just these kind of societal pressures, again, when you're a star, I guess, at this point. Goody two shoes, it goes on there. Don't drink, don't smoke, what do you do? And I see here also on songfacts.com that apparently he didn't, I guess, drink or smoke, but one vice that he had at this point, as it is put here, by the 1980s, his only vice was sex, no drugs, alcohol, or even cigarettes for Adam Ant. And it goes on, this led to predictable questions from the press. If he didn't drink or smoke, then what exactly did he do? And it goes on, it seems hard to believe that he was normal, whatever. And I guess it says, Adam was very measured and reasonable in interviews, nothing like the war paint wearing wild man who showed up on stage. And again, that's just because I, as somebody who doesn't know a lot about Adam, but I do know that, you know, some stars, I think about a guy like Bo Burnham, who is very different off stage than on stage. Again, these people who put on, you know, these characters kind of things or whatever, put on the face paint, whatever, and they go out to make a show because these people paid for that kind of a show. And then when they get off stage, they're their own self, whatever. It's just like, and then some people expect them to be on all the time. And it's just, again, it's just nuts. Anyway, we don't follow fashion. That'd be a joke. You know, we're going to set them so everyone could take note. When they saw you kneeling, crying words that you mean, opening their eyeballs, pretending that you're Al Green. Again, just these people always looking at you and, you know, again, making stuff up, whatever it is, and just wanting to hang on to anything that you do. And then we go into the part again, the chorus, whatever. Don't drink, don't smoke, what do you do? Don't drink, don't smoke, what do you do? Subtle innuendos follow. Must be something inside. And again, the whole point of subtle innuendos, I guess, you know, he must have made some innuendos and songs, whatever. And I guess, as I said there earlier, he liked sex or whatever. Talking about innuendos, all this stuff comes to mind. And again, must be something inside. Again, just kind of making stuff up. Must be something there that comes to mind too. And again, the whole point of, you know, goody two shoes, just again, trying to be a goody two shoes in the eyes of the media and the eyes of the people. And, you know, that's hard to keep up that kind of a, you know, thing when it's maybe not true, you know, when you're going through other stuff and you're not really a goody two shoes. Anyway, no one's going to tell me what's wrong and what's right. Again, Adam kind of showing, you know, I'm my own kind of person, whatever, or tell me who to eat with, sleep with, or what I've, or that I've won the big fight. Again, just kind of saying, you know, I'm going to be myself no matter what. No one's going to tell me what to do, whatever. Whether it's, you know, your manager or whatever the hell, you know, I'm going to be myself anyway. Look out or they'll tell you you're a superstar 2 weeks and you're all and you're an all-time legend. Because again, sometimes people do you know, pump you up, and it's just like, then you get a big ego, and I mean, my God, it's happened, obviously, to so many different people. I think the games have gone much too far, and the words unspoken get stuck in your throat. Send a treasure token, write it on a pound note. And then we finish off that chorus once again, where it's just kind of repeated over and over. And again, these people just wanting to know more about you. You don't drink, you don't smoke. What do you do? You know, tell us. Good Lord, we have to know. And again, this doesn't even have to be, I guess, about a star. I mean, this can be put for other people who feel rebellious in these ways or not conforming to society, whatever you want to say. I guess it's just being yourself. And again, that's the whole point. You know, I think of the song by Audioslave, Be Yourself. And my goodness, you know, to be yourself is all that you can do. I mean, my God, it's so simple, but it's such a profound message. And again, Adam showing here, you know, don't come down to these people and don't try to be a goody two shoes, whatever. Don't try to live your life that, you know, live a false life, I guess, in a way. You know, just be you and in front of these people still, whether you're a star or not. You know, these kind of things come to mind. And again, I just love the way he went about this and kind of had fun with it. And but at the same time, you know, obviously this is something he struggled with, I guess you would say, because he put it, you know, he made a song out of it and these kind of pressures or whatever that he was facing. And, you know, he took this and made it a great debut single, obviously. And, you know, I'm listening to it all these years later. So there we go. But anyway, I guess that's all I gotta say. Actually, there is a quote here I just wanted to talk about, because Adam Ant, you know, made the song, and I just wanted to put this out there. And he said of the song here, Goody Two Shoes was sort of an answer back manifesto and just trying to keep things level headed, because I felt that, and still do to a degree, that going on stage is creating an illusion. It's magical and it's wonderful, and I love doing it, but off stage there has to be a timeout. So there again, just kind of, you know, summing up everything I talked about. On stage, you might have some kind of persona that people expect you to have off of it, but that might not be the true case. And how he's kind of just saying that there, you know, when you're off stage, you know, there has to be that time out from people, especially asking questions, whatever, just leave me alone for a second, this kind of a thing. But you might not get that. You might not get what you want from the, you know, the press when you're a star. But anyway, there we go. Love the song. Love the idea. Love the message here. Again, love the saxophone and trumpet on it. My God. And I guess that's all I got to say. So thanks for watching. This is a long one. Good Lord. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. Really appreciate all the support. And I'll talk to you guys again soon.